What kind of software do people use to make figures or tables? Excel is used quite frequently. Now, I would not recommend that you output the default Excel graphs. That looks pretty amateur. If you do use Excel, then you need to make a lot of changes so that they look professional and, you know, not just quickly slapped together. A lot of people will export their figures into Photoshop or Illustrator to clean them up and make them look better. ImageJ is a software that's similar to Photoshop, but it's a free version provided by the NIH. SigmaPlot is commonly used, Cricut Graph. A lot of people are using R these days to make figures, and R is a pretty powerful program that makes really nice looking visuals. And there are probably other ways to do it that I haven't mentioned here. So going back to this idea of readability and making the reader's job easy, let's look at these points. First, make sure you're using large enough lettering and large enough symbols that when your figure is printed the size that it will be printed in the final journal article, that it's still easy to read. A common mistake I see is that people are using too small of a font size or too small symbols. I don't want to pull out a magnifying glass to be able to read the figures. Also, with symbols, it's not just about size, but it's also about distinguishing them. So it can be hard to tell a diamond from a circle sometimes, especially on certain types of graphs, like scatter plots. Be aware of overlapping lines or curves. If you're making line graphs, if the curves are overlapping each other, it can be really hard for the eye to trace which curve is which. And if you have too many lines or curves in the graph, it makes it crowded. Consider breaking that figure into multiple panels. If you're going to use fill patterns or shading or colors, do that effectively and in a subtle way. Don't use colors that are harsh and hard to view. Choose colors that work well together. And if you're using shading, make sure you can distinguish the shades. If you're using multiple lines on a line graph, consider using different line weights and line patterns. That makes it easier to follow with the eye. And if you must use color, make sure that you're using color in a way that information is not lost if your readers print your paper in black and white. And also make sure you include statistical analysis information on the figure using symbols or letters or whatever is appropriate for that type of graph and in your field. Let's look at a couple of examples of figures that I think could have been done better. So this first one is a scatter plot, and it has a curve fit on it, which is fine. The problem is that they have four different data sets plotted together, and the only way to distinguish the data points in each data set is by color, and the symbols are exactly the same. So if you print this figure in black and white, all that information is going to disappear. You're just going to see a lot of dots. What the authors could have done is, you know, made the red dots diamonds and made the green dots squares and made the blue dots triangles. Different symbols could be potentially distinguished. Additionally, green and red are not ideal colors to use because there is a substantial percentage of people in the population that are red-green colorblind. Here's another example of a figure that I think could have been done better. So what we see here is on the left side a color version of this figure, and on the right side I've printed the same figure in black and white. This is a figure that shows a bar graph, and I think the layout of the bar graph looks fine. They've got groupings of different genotypes that have been harvested at different times during the year, and they're comparing the yield. What I think could have been done better is with the color and the fill patterns. When we look at the color version, to me, the colors that they chose are just not very pleasant to look at. They kind of hurt my eyes. The orange and the yellow and the black, their contrast is very harsh. And then there are some that are not even colored. If you're going to use colors, I feel like it's better to use a set of colors that go together, that designers have determined are pleasing to the eye together. And then when we print the figure in black and white, we lose a lot of information. And now some of the bars colors are indistinguishable. None of these bars have any fill patterns. So if they had used fill patterns, then when we go to black and white, we wouldn't have lost that information. All right, it is time for your action list for this week. This is a shorter list than in some of the different weeks. However, there's still a lot to do when you make figures and tables. The first thing I want you to do is finish analyzing your data if you haven't done that already, and then determine the best way to present that data. Third, go ahead and make all of your figures and tables. So the last action item is to write down the main take-home message for each figure and table. So what I do is after I make a figure or a table, I print it on a piece of paper, and then I take a pencil or a pen and I write down what I feel like is the key message that I'm going to present in the results section. And I call that the take-home message. So what do you want the readers to walk away from your figure remembering about that figure? What is the result that they should see in that figure? It might be more than one result, but let's start with the most important one and get that written down. Okay, to wrap up the lesson, let's reiterate the learning outcomes for this lesson. At the conclusion of the lesson, make sure you can determine when to use a figure or when to use a table, and which type of figure to use if you're going to use a figure, and be able to explain the concepts of figure design and presentation in terms of readability and making the reader's job easy. All right, that's all I have for you for this week. Go ahead and make sure you accomplish these learning objectives before you move on to the next lesson, and happy writing!